Hello everyone, let's move on to the second topic on this unit, that is chromatic aberration. In order to explain the chromatic aberration, we need to understand the dispersion of the prism. Now consider a prism which is having three sides are equal and also each angle is equal to 60 degrees. As a result, the total number of angles in this equilateral triangle is 180 degrees. When a white light is incident on this prism, then the white light gets dispersed. This we can see in this figure. In case of prism is not there, then this white light ray goes straight without any deviation. But due to the presence of the prism, the white light ray splits into 7 colors in the prism. Hence, these splitted 7 colors are gets refracted from the prism and forms images at different locations. These 7 colors are called Wibzer. That means the formed images are in the order of violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. In this figure, we can observe that deviation produced by violet ray delta V is greater than the deviation produced by red light ray delta R. This analogy is useful for the future explanation of chromatic aberration. This phenomena is called dispersion. So, similarly, the chromatic aberration occurs not only in the prism, but also occurs in the lenses also. So, what is chromatic aberration? A single lens produces a colored image of an object that is illuminated by white light. This is called chromatic aberration. Now, we will look into the explanation. Imagine the lens is made up of large number of small truncated prisms. In this animation, we can observe that the convex lens contains large number of small and small prisms. Now, take any prism on this lens. For example, if we consider the upper prism on the lens, then the white light ray coming from the point object is incident on this prism. Consider that the point object is situated at infinite. In case lens is not there, then this white light ray goes straight without any deviation. But due to the presence of lens, the white light ray splits into 7 colors. That means it gets dispersion. Because from the formula deviation, we can write as a delta is equal to h by f. This we already studied in the first topic. So therefore implies delta proportional to 1 by f. Here f means focal length of the lens and height h is constant here. Hence we consider as a delta proportional to 1 by f. But we know that mu proportional to 1 by lambda. Here mu is refractive index, lambda is the wavelength of light. But from the lens maker's formula, 1 by f is equal to mu minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. This formula is for single lens. Here r1 and r2 are radii of lens which are constant. Hence directly we can write as a 1 by f proportional to mu. From the preceding equations, directly we can write as a delta proportional to 1 by lambda. Here the wavelength of red light ray is greater than the violet light ray. Hence, the deviation produced by red light ray is lesser than violet light ray. Hence, this phenomena also occurs in the prism. Therefore, at first, the splitted violet light ray forms an image at FV on the principal axis. Similarly, the splitted red light ray forms an image at FR on the principal axis. The remaining colors of the light rays forms images in between violet and red images. Here the value FR is greater than FE. Hence, the chromatic aberration for the convex lens D capital F is equal to FR minus FE is always positive. Here the important formula is lambda V less than lambda R implies delta V greater than delta R. Similarly, the chromatic aberration occurs in concave lens also. For example, if you take a point object in front of the concave lens, then the white light ray is incident on the concave lens. In case lens is not there, then this white light ray goes straight line without any deviation. But due to the presence of lens, the white light ray splits into 7 colors. That means it gets dispersion, namely Wibzer. In this animation, if you extend to the back side of violet and red rays, then it forms images on the principal axis at FE and FR respectively. Here chromatic aberration D capital F is equal to FR minus FE is always negative because FE is greater than FR in concave lens. This we can observe in this animation. Similarly, the chromatic aberration occurs for white light point object which is situated on the principal axis also. These animations are shown in both convex lens and concave lens. That means chromatic aberration occurs for any object situated at any point from the lens. Now for example, take line object. In line object also, the chromatic aberration also can occur. For example, consider convex lens which is having principal axis. Now consider a line object AB on the principal axis as shown in the figure. From the point A, the white light ray passes through center of the lens along the principal axis. This white light ray should not deviate along any direction because it passes through center of the lens. The white light ray coming from B travels parallel to principal axis and incident on lower end of the lens as shown in this animation. In case if the lens is not there, then this white light ray goes straight without any deviation. But due to the presence of lens, the white light ray deviate into violet ray and red light ray. Similarly, the white light ray coming from B incident on upper end of the lens, in case lens is not there, then this white light ray goes straight without any deviation. But due to the presence of lens, the white light ray deviate into violet light ray and red light ray. The violet light rays which are meeting at the point forms an violet line image AVBV from the principal axis. Similarly, the red light rays which are meeting at the point forms an red line image ARBR from the principal axis. Here, in the principal axis forms an longitudinal aberration that is called X is equal to AR minus AV. And also forms an lateral chromatic aberration Y is equal to ARBR minus AVBV. Hence, two chromatic aberrations occur for line object. These two chromatic aberrations are mutually perpendicular to each other. That means, if you take a white light ray object, then the images are formed on principal axis in a regular order manner such that the line images are violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red images are formed. In this animation, we can see that the magnification of red image line is greater than the magnification of violet image line. The remaining line images are formed in between violet and red images lines. This is the example picture. And the left hand side of the picture contains PGM. And that PGM which is having border of colorful light. This would indicate it contains chromatic aberration. Whereas the right hand side picture contains original picture of PGM having no chromatic aberration at all. Similarly, we can see several other pictures, images that contains chromatic aberration in each border. So, this is our topic. So, please subscribe our Telugu Gamanam channel for more lecture videos. Click the bell icon for notifications. If you want to get lecture notes for this lecture video, click the description link below in the lecture video. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the next lecture video. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.